Alright, hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. This is Rob from Smirking Gun Reviews, and we're back with more Orange is the New Black Season 6. We're at episode 4. I'm the talking ass. I could be. Maybe I am. Anyway, full spoilers if you haven't seen the episode yet. Another great episode. More layers being upheaved on this season. So yeah, if you haven't seen it, come on back. So, more, you know, people trying to figure out what the hell's going on. Like, who's told on who and what, you know. So, still more just trying to figure out, you know, who you can trust, things like that. And one person for sure you can't trust is Badison. You can tell she's the big bad for this season, except maybe she's just one part of it. It's, you know, a trickle-down effect. You've got Carol, or is it Karen? One of the two. That's Berlin's old, you know, person that she's afraid of. And then there's Barbara. Those people that were running Max and Badison's kind of like a lieutenant in this kind of thing. You know, like, they're a little mob. She, as the song at the end of the episode says, she's batshit crazy, and she really is. She's always trying to do something to just humiliate you eventually. She has plans. She doesn't do anything without some sort of, you know, fuck you at the end of it. Maybe not right away, but you can just tell she's a goddamn nut job. And so I'm more worried about her than I am the other two that are kind of running the place. Chapman finally finds Alex, who had been in the hospital, so she wasn't dead. I mean, we all knew that. It kept saying Aunt Laura Prebon in the credits, and it turns out that it's Suzanne's girlfriend that died, which, I mean, I can't remember everything from every detail last season, but I knew something was going on, and I wasn't sure if they showed her death or not. I'm not 100% on that, but so her and Alex are back together, and of course that's something that Badison is going to try to help, but you can just tell with the way she deals with the girl at the end of the episode that hesitated. They threatened her, and I'm sure that she's got plans. Maybe she doesn't even know. Maybe she's more like the Joker in a way, where she just does things. We got Elaida on the outside, who I'm starting to think is going to end up back in jail. I kind of thought that when she got out, that she'd be right back in. But I'm starting to think that maybe because Diaz is looking like she's never getting out, that maybe she'll go back in, because she's not doing well. Now that she knows that she's never going to see her daughter, like, outside again, it may give her the motivation to do something to get herself back in. That, I can't speak to the connection that a mother and a daughter have, but, I mean, I don't know. That's devotion, if that's what happens. The whole thing with Nikki and her, more of her backstory, is great, because you get to... Her dad, played by, I had his name, and now it's gone. But he's been in a lot of cool stuff, like Matchstick Men, but most recently what I really like him in is Mr. Robot. He's great. Man, that's killing me that I forgot this guy's name. I didn't get the list right here. And if it's not coming up, come on, where is that dude's name? Damn it. Yeah, dead air, just to find some dude's name that's not even written in here. Anyway, her backstory and how she, you know, it just basically telling more of the way that she had to go to prison to find her real parent. Because her parents just kind of use her as a chip to piss each other off. Her dad doesn't care about her. He's with a child. Oh my goodness, did you see the age of that wow. Talk about your winter summer romance. She looked like she was maybe only a couple of years, a few years older than Nikki. So yeah, it's just more of how Red's showing that she's more the parent, and the struggle that Nikki's going through to not get herself, more time in jail, and trying to get that across to Red, and it finally, it finally comes across. It finally is okay. And Red wouldn't want that from her, but Red's really getting screwed over. And at least now she's starting to see, what the feds are doing, what this all is about. It's about creating distrust. It's about creating chaos. It's about just, doing what they have to get what they want, no matter who, whose lives they ruin on the way. Truth, it doesn't even matter really to them as long as they have results. And that's kind of messed. That's pretty messed up. Because it doesn't seem like anybody really gives a shit about Piscatella being dead. It's just finding out who they can pin it on to make it all go away. The thing with Tasty finally reaching out to Caputo, which is something I thought would happen, that at some point he would have to get involved to try to start to piece this together. Hopefully he can start figuring some of the conspiracy out. I don't know. Maybe he'll be able to talk to some of those guys and see what really happened. That would be great. But that's kind of a stretch, so I don't know how it's all gonna play out, but geez, what else? I like the whole the lady on the radio. That's really good. That's pretty funny. Aleta snapping on that guard. Man, that guy is a real piece of shit, and I think he's the one that puts a lot of beatings on Diaz, so. Yeah, it's a good thing that she didn't know that. Daggett's story at the Playland and everything, they're starting to come around to the big guy who defends them in front of a couple of, just pretty stereotypical Daggett's, the kind of characters that just do that in episodes of TV just to do it. But, he's starting to come around, but I don't know. I don't know how long this little fantasy trip that they're taking can last before it kind of crumbles. But yeah, I'm trying to think of anything else that's in here, but it's another good episode. I gotta get to the next one. So I think that's about it that I'm getting. Diaz is pretty much, given up. We haven't seen Suzanne, I think, in this episode. Poor Red. This should be a little interesting how this goes because friggin' she wasn't having none of Battison's looks. Like, you could just see her looking across the table. Alex was just like straight. Her eyes were not friendly. So we're gonna see how much more of that goes. I think that's all I got. I'm sure I'm missing something. But anyway, if you like this video, please hit the like button. Like, comment, share, subscribe. We're at 177 subscribers. So we're getting there. We're getting close. Let's hit 180 or something pretty soon. Hit the bell for any notifications. I got plenty of stuff on the channel to watch. We got comic reviews. We've got Man of the High Castle. We've got, oh gosh, I was going to do an Ant-Man and the Wasp review, but I haven't done it yet. So anyway, this is Robert Smirking Interview saying thanks for all the support. Thanks for watching these videos, and we will see you on the next one. Have a good one.